Oi!
Get back to your house.
Not my house anymore, Harry.
Husband's gone bankrupt. There's a notice in this morning's paper.
Good job we got paid first then, isn't it?
You haven't swigged what I'm getting on about, have you?
With you, Harry, that's a certainty.
Well, if he's gone broke, he'll need every penny he can find, and the reserve value of that house will go right down.
Oof, my heart bleeds for him.
What I'm saying is, if it does go down, you can buy it back again.
Oh, yeah. I'll buy a villa in Spain to go with it as well.
Suit yourself. Just came over to tip you off.
Thanks. I don't think I'd go back even if I could afford it.
Might ask our captain to try for it. I might buy the Fleming thing for him if I could see that baby.
Oh, yeah, how is he? I thought you were bringing him round to show me.
You know, these young ones, they're always too busy. I've hardly seen him myself.
Well, you hurry up and bring him round, otherwise people will say you've dreamt him up. See ya.
Thanks.
Rob? Kirsty? Do you want a cuppa?
No.
Well, there was no need to be so rude. Where have I wanted one?
Well, go and get one if you want.
I haven't got time. Look, I want to show you these invitations and place cards. Janice's brother, you know, the one who works at our studio place, he designed them. I don't think they're right, though. I mean, this printing should be bigger, don't you think?
That looks okay to me.
No, it isn't. People aren't going to be able to read it. Can you tell the printer to make it bigger?
Me?
Well, I can't go down there. I've got to go to work in a minute.
Would it be better if you explained it?
What's the matter with you? I've been running around in circles trying to organise this wedding, but what have you done?
You know more about it, that's all I'm saying.
And I've just told you how I want it. It's only going to take you half an hour, surely that's not too much to ask.
All right, I'll take it. Just stop going on about it.
There's no need to be like that. And what's up with you?
Nothing.
Well, you were dead quiet at ours last night, even my mum noticed.
Nothing, I've told you.
Look, I know something's wrong.
Look, there's nothing wrong.
All right.
Hi, love. Just made a sandwich, do you want one?
No, it's all right, I've got this.
Don't usually come home for your dinner?
No.
Thought you usually went round the shops with your friend.
She's off sick. I wish I'd never listened to you. I wish I'd never gone back there.
Why not?
Well, no one will talk to me. Can't stand sitting in that restroom without Nicky.
Give him time, love. They'll get over it.
They don't like me.
No, you can't say that. What have you ever done to them?
Well, I took the bosses to the tribunal, didn't I? Well, they think I'm trouble. If they're seen talking to me, and the bosses will think they're troublemakers as well.
You sure you're not imagining this?
No, you haven't seen them. They go all quiet when I walk in the room. And I can hear them whispering behind me back. You're not in trouble again?
No, just leave it, eh?
Well, there's something. We're supposed to be getting married, why can't you tell me? Rod?
It was a car crash I was at on Saturday. I had to sit with this fella while he was dying. He lived with his mum. Did everything for his mum. But he didn't have the guts to tell her that he was leaving just to go and live with his girlfriend. I wish she'd been there when he died.
She might have been killed.
No, but she shouldn't have had to hear it from me.
But she heard it, that's what matters. She'll really appreciate it.
Oh.
She will, Rod, she will. I know. We had this little lad brought in the other week, he was only 10. Fallen off a raft or something into the canal. But he was still alive when they brought him in. We did everything we could. At one point his eyes flickered and I could have swore he said Mum. And a minute later he died. I'm gonna have my noses in.
I think you're making a big mistake. Don't you want this?
No.
Oh, Tracy, I really do think you're making a big mistake. Well, you stood up for yourself. Why let them force you out because of that?
See ya.
They do have do-it-yourself shops in Liverpool, you know. That's if it's not too much for your own dad to ask. You'll find out when you get here, won't you? Three months old, haven't even got a photograph. Hey, Monty, get away from that pond.
Why don't you bring in sick? I don't think I'm so sad.
I can't.
You can't go into work like this.
I'm all right. I'm just feeling an idiot for crying like that.
That's my fault. I never realised.
I just want to get on with the arrangements. Hi.
Hiya. Hiya.
I'll ring you.
OK.
You won't forget about the princess?
No.
Bye.
Ta-ra. Ta-ra, Kirsty. Hey, there's more people looking at your old house there.
Yeah, there were loads at the weekend. Why don't you and Kirsty go after it?
No, I don't think so.
Well, Harry Cross reckons it's going to go for a lower price. You never know.
Oh, getting married's hard enough without bidding for houses.
Is everything all right? Kirsty looked a bit upset.
Yeah, it's just something at work.
Oh.
A little kid fell off a raft into the canal. He died in intensive care.
Oh, God. No wonder she looked upset.
It's part of the job, innit?
Yeah, I suppose it is, really.
I am sorry about before. Kirsty said I was rude when I shouted down. I'm sorry.
Oh, it's all right. I can take it.
Where's Rhoda?
Come in.
All right, all right. What are you doing here?
Come to drag you out of bed. Mind you, I noticed Kirsty had gone.
That's enough of that.
Now, I was going to see you come down the gym, do some weights.
I don't know, I've got to go and see the printer about the wedding stuff.
Oh, come on, it'll do you good. And with a bit of luck, I won't get dragged into anything.
Yeah, all right, I'll just go and get me stuff.
Nice one. How are you doing, Mrs. Grant?
I'm all right, love, thanks.
I gave you a bit of a shock then. Your Damon and that. Brought it back to me and all, you know. Sorry.
It's all right.
I've done that job a few times since, but I don't think you'd ever forget the first time. I know I won't.
It's a day I won't forget in a hurry either.
It was Rod's first time on Saturday. It was a bit of a nasty one. That's why I'm here. I don't know how he did it.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll see you, Mrs. Grant. Yeah, sorry, Eva. You know.
It's all right. Rod?
Yeah?
You're going to be back for your tea?
Yeah, please. Ta-ra.
Bye now.
All right, Jay. They told you then.
What?
The police.
Where's Rod and his mate?
No.
Why, where is it? What's happened?
It's Bobby, she. He was in an accident last night.
I see. Okay. Will you tell him I phoned then? All right. Thank you. Bye.
How is he, she?
Just said he's comfortable.
That's what they told George Williams this morning. Soft, isn't it?
Comfortable. And you've just been in a car crash. He was very lucky, she.
What was he doing in Reading?
Oh, some sort of business at head office, it seems.
Is anybody else hurt?
Not as far as George knows. It was a badly lit road and he ran off into a wall or a tree or something.
You know, I don't think I'll ever be able to see a police car again without shivering. That lad in the police car with Rod. He was the one who came to tell us about Damon. Both recognised each other. It's been some sort of an omen.
Oh, he's gonna be all right, Chi.
I suppose I better get down there. Will you help out with Claire for a few days?
Oh, you know I will.
I'll ring about the trains. I better phone Billy.
Look, Chi, I'll have Claire. I mean, you're welcome, you know that. But what good's it going to do, you know? I mean, he's got a few fractured ribs, a broken arm, a few bruises. But he's going to be all right. And you're going to get upset.
It's all so complicated.
I know that, kid. And I'm sorry about Easter Sunday. I shouldn't have went on at you like that, you know what I mean? But it was the shock, you know, finding out about you and Billy. Hey, come on, drink up.
Hey, Rob, don't go doing yourself an injury. Kirsty won't be interested in anyone who's not fit on the weather, ain't you know?
No danger.
Why, getting plenty of practice with Emma, are you?
What'd you say?
You heard.
I told you. There's nothing going on.
Anything you say, Rod. Mind you, seem to do a lot of talking, you used to.
We're just good mates, that's all. Come on, I'll race you 50 times. Ah! Stab wound still hurting.
No, no way. It's going to take more than that little get to put me out of action.
Hey, I hope we run into him again sometime.
Never mind, we. I'm first. If he opens his mouth, I'll do him. Mind you, we'll have to wait. He's still on your mind in Risley.
Still something to look forward to, though, isn't
it? Yeah. Mind you, by the time he's done a few years, he'll probably stop acting the goat with knives.
Yeah, well, still plenty more of them out there, isn't there?
Yeah, well, they're not going to catch me. Because I'm going to get mega fit. Take more than Tyson to do me next time. You ready?
Yeah.
Go.
Come on.
See, if I was still married to Bob, well, still living with him, I'd have been on my way down there by now, worrying out of my mind. It's just not there, though.
Listen, there's no need for you to worry or feel guilty.
Matty, I'm not worried. But I do feel guilty.
Oh, come on. You can't feel guilty because the other fella was crazy enough to drive into a tree.
No, it's got nothing to do with that, Matty. When you told me about the accident, just for a minute, just for an instant, I thought you were going to tell me that he was dead.
I'm sorry, but you know the police
car... No, I don't mean that. I mean, I jumped at the chance. I jumped at the chance of thinking he might be dead. An easy way out of my marriage.
Oh, come on, Sheila, I can't believe that.
Well, I'm sorry, but it's true. And I feel ashamed. And I do feel guilty. Because it would have been an easy way out of my marriage. I'd have been a widow, free to marry Billy. And just for a minute, that's what went through my head.
Well, that's hard to believe.
It's hard to believe a year ago that I'd be living with a man who wasn't my husband. Oh, you're right, Matty. I mean, my instinct is I should be rushing down to Reading. But in the end, when I think about it, I don't want to go because I want to stay here with Billy.
Is this what you really want? Here with Billy? I mean, are you sure of him?
Mm.
Oh, I don't know.
Yes, I am sure. I love him.
Then forget the guilt, OK?
It's not that easy, Matty.
Oh, look, Sheila. After Teresa, I wallowed in guilt. But you've got to force yourself out of it. Look, I know it's not quite the same, but... Well, I felt guilty because she killed herself over me and me carrying on. And you feel guilty because you're breaking all the rules. Well, life's short. Put it all behind you. Live for the day.
And what about the church? Is there going to be a place for me there after all this?
Oh, I should think so, Sheila.
Wish I knew where it was.
Look, are you going to be all right?
Yeah.
Do you want me to phone your body? I was going to, you know, but...
No, I'll do it. Thanks.
So this year I won't have to sit here listening to your exploits in the smoke. I'll be right there beside you. OK. Yeah, cheers. Yeah, I'll see you at the weekend.
Anthony, I wonder whether I could have a word.
Ah, just the girl I wanted to see. How do you fancy a free trip to London?
Me?
Come look at this. The Hairdresser and Beautician of the Year competition at Wembley. Guess who's been asked to take part?
You.
My first month here as well. Nice one, eh?
Yeah, that's great.
Does that mean you will come down with me and Tina?
Why me?
Because you're good at your job. Tina will need someone to help her. Someone who knows what they're doing. And more importantly, someone who wants to do the job. Have you ever been to London?
Yeah, I went looking for jobs once.
It's a 4-star hotel. You'll see the cream of the profession down there, Tracy. You'll learn a lot. Now, you, me and Tina will have to get our heads together as soon as possible. We need to find some models, too.
Yeah.
What was it you wanted?
Just the stock book.
Right. There you go. If anyone wants me, I'll be phoning a few mates. Boasting.
So you're working for your promotion now, then?
Me?
Yeah, not when you get married.
Yeah, well, can't do my sergeant's exam for ages, yeah.
What about you?
Just enjoying myself, aren't I?
Yeah, and while you're doing that, all the rookies will be passing before you.
Yeah, well, I won't be a bobby forever.
I could be had a word with you about specialising.
No?
Yes, with me. He's keen on this community policing, but I don't ever want to do it.
Oh, you want to go for CID? Loads more freedom.
Yeah, loads more late nights and still having to get up in the morning, though.
Still, better than doing Punch and Judy shows about the Green Cross Code, innit?
Come on, children. What does Punch say?
Yeah, well, there's loads of ways you can go.
Yeah, all the way up to Chief Constable, yeah. I'm not so sure about me. You might do. Yeah, do you fancy a swim before you clock on?
Yeah, all right. Another 50 before we go, eh?
No problem. Go.
Hi. Tell them all the news, have you?
No.
No?
Look, I want to tell you something. I wanted to tell you before, but... Well, you started on about London and all that.
Yeah?
I've decided to hand in my notice.
Your notice? You've only just come back. What about London?
I'd love to go. Thanks for asking, but...
It's crazy to leave now. It's crazy to leave at all.
Look, I'm just not happy anymore. Well, no one wants to talk to me. That woman called me a bitch. That's exactly what everyone thinks I am.
People are bound to make stupid remarks. You were in the right. Ignore them. Come and sit down. Please.
Was doing me head in? I thought they were supposed to be my mates. Well, they were. If I tell them about London, they'll just have to make something of that as well.
What if they do? It'll be you going to London, not them. But I want you at this competition because you're good at your job. If you weren't, I'd have sacked you last week. I understand what you've been through with Gerard, what you're going through now, but why did it put you off? You've got a future, Tracy. Think about that. I won't accept your notice.
It's up to me if I want to leave.
Yeah, of course it is. All I'm doing is asking you to think about it a bit more.
I have thought.
No, really think.
I have really thought.
Don't say any more. Get your coat and go home early. One more day isn't going to make any difference, is it?
You just don't understand, Dad.
There's nothing to understand. You're my son. He's my grandson. Grandparents do have rights, you know. And I think you've treated me terrible.
Sit down. You won't do your heart any good getting all excited.
I'm all right as I am. What if I do have a bad turn? What if it killed me? I'd die having spent little or no time with my own grandson.
You're just being stupid and melodramatic. Calm down. You've got to take into account Sal's condition. It's difficult for her. She feels very protective about Tim at the moment, but it won't last forever.
And I won't last for flaming ever, either. Why can't you bring him over if she's not well?
She won't let him out of her sight. How many times do I have to tell you?
Well, why can't she come over with him?
She's hardly set foot out of the house since she came out of hospital.
I'll come over there for a few weeks. I could help.
I'm sorry, Dad, but I have to say no. Sal needs as much peace as she can get at the moment, just the family round her.
I am flaming family.
You're making this very difficult, Dad.
The boy's important to me.
I know that, but just bear with me.
Here, read that. That's how important.
What is it?
Read it. That's if you can spare me 10 minutes of your valuable time.
Yeah, there'll be three of us. Yeah, myself, Tina Carroll, and one to be confirmed. Yeah. Oh, hold on. Yeah, I think I can confirm the junior. Yeah. Tracy Corkhill. That's right. Corkhill. Thanks. Bye.
When did you get this drawn up?
Oh, I've been thinking about it all since he was born.
All changed in favour of Tim.
Oh, it's not changed yet. That's just advice from the solicitor.
Well, it's very kind of you.
Yes, but we don't know his name, do we? Haynes Old Cross.
Oh, Dad, not all that again.
Look, you've got a son, and you should be married.
How many times do I have to tell you?
Well, what about the endowment policy?
It's very impressive.
He'd be 21 when that matured, and he'd have more money than ever I've had in my lifetime. But I've got to know his name.
You know his name? Tim Haynes.
Well, you won't want to see this, will you?
Dad.
Don't you want the best for your own son?
Of course I do.
I can go to the cat's home, then.
Don't be ridiculous.
I'd do it, don't you worry, son.
Then you'd better do it, hadn't you?
You what?
Leave all your money to the cat's home. Leave it to whoever you like. Because if changing Tim's name is your price for leaving your money to your own flesh and blood, you can keep it. I'm going.
Kevin! Son!
You'll see, Tim. All you've got to do is wait. But if you try that cheap kind of blackmail on me once more, I'll think twice about you ever seeing him again. All right.
Jimmy's next, and one woman finds herself back in hospital just 2 days after the filming of a gallbladder operation.
Walk.
A walk? Now?
There's plenty of time. Don't fuss.
But you haven't had the morning I've had. She was an hour late at the hairdresser's. She keeps stopping to talk to people. She even spent 10 minutes talking to a traffic warden.
It's her big day. Let her enjoy herself. Gordon's with her. He'll see she gets here.
He hasn't forgiven us for last week.
What?
At the dinner party.
Oh, don't worry about that now.
It's a pity Lucy couldn't make it.
Wouldn't he manage to reply?
You know, Mother keeps talking about Father.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Well, this is hardly the time to start talking about her late husband. Jack this, Jack that.
Bound to bring back memories.
Oh, yes, she can remember everything that happened 30 years ago. But you try asking her to remember if she packed her new shoes. Where is he?
Gerald, 20 minutes to go.
Is he all right? Matron's been telling me some terrible stories about old people getting married. And he's not too old to back out at the altar. Are you sure he's all right?
Perhaps he doesn't really want me to be best man. The bridegroom who usually chooses, not the bride.
Don't bring that up now.
Your mother press-ganged him into asking me, as if I hadn't got enough to do, sorting out Teddy's so-called arrangements.
I think I'll just go and see if he's all right.
Might be better if you help the supporters' club into the church. Leave him to me. Feeling all right, Gerald?
Good afternoon, ladies. We were so glad you could come.
Yes.
Did you have a good journey?
Hi, Dad.
You've brought him. Hey, let's have a look at him.
Careful, careful.
Wouldn't be more careful with the crown jewels. He's a cross, all right. You can tell that right away.
Hey, I'm sorry about the other day, Dad.
You changed your mind?
No.
Still, you brought him to see me.
Not for long, I'm afraid. I had to go back to the DIY place to pick up what I've ordered. So I persuaded Sal to let me come visit him with him.
You'll be stopping for tea and that?
Well, we really ought to be off soon.
You've only just arrived. Surely you'll spend some time with him.
Sal will get jumpy if he's away too long.
You go shopping. He'll be in good care here.
Dad, you don't know anything about babies.
Well, you didn't, I?
It was 37 years ago.
Look, go on, son. He'll be in good care here. You won't be long, will you?
Well, I suppose not, no.
Go on, then. What are you waiting for? Move.
All right. I'll just get his bottle and things out of the car.
Hello there.
You're sure you have the ring, Paul?
Safe and sound.
Oh, right.
Are you sure she knows what time the service starts?
Well, even if she doesn't, Gordon does.
Right, I'm off. What are you doing?
Writing to Bob.
Have you rang him since this morning?
No, I'll do it after tea.
Look, you know what he said last night about going to Redden and that? Well, I don't mind if you do.
It wouldn't do any good. The hardest bit's trying to explain it to him.
Right, I'll see you then, eh?
See you.
Sheila there.
Come in, Annie. What have you got there?
Me grandson, now do you believe me?
Let's have a look at him. Oh, isn't he lovely? Oh, what's his name?
Tim.
Hey, he's a dead ringer for you, isn't he?
He is, you're right.
You're not visiting then, is he, Harry?
Well, I'm minding him for a bit. Kevin's had to go into town on business.
Oh, that's nice.
Sorry, mate, sir, but I've got to go, right? See you, love.
See you.
Mm-hmm. Might be minding him regular now. Kevin and Sally, they need a break now and again.
Oh, that's good of you, Harry. Look, Harry's grandson come to see us.
Very nice, Harry. Congratulations.
You'll be having one of these shortly.
What? A grandson?
A baby, soft lad.
I don't know about that one. Anyway, I'm off.
See ta-da. You, love.
Well, Gran, here we are.
I think I'll have to talk to the vicar.
Well, time's getting on.
But I don't want to do the wrong thing. You do agree, don't you?
Yeah, but, you know.
No, I can't go any further until I've seen the vicar. Go and fetch him.
You absolutely sure?
Positive.
By the way, Gran, I meant to tell you earlier. You look beautiful.
Thank you, dear.
That's your dad when he was a nipper. That was a day out at Southend. Your old granddad looks fitter there, doesn't he? And this is Grandma Edna. Look at that smile, eh? I wish he could see you. If only he'd have just come a few years earlier.
Are you sure you ordered the car at the right time?
Of course I'm sure.
You didn't rely on Teddy's arrangements.
Give me some credit.
Problem.
Where's Mother?
Yes, where is she?
She's in the car. She's having second thoughts.
Second thoughts?
What? Second thoughts about the service. I knew it. She's going to jilt me. It happened to me once in 1932.
No, I don't think she will, Gerald. She just wants to have a word with the vicar.
Now? Do you know what time it is?
She insists, Mum.
Oh, I knew she'd make problems. What does she want to talk to the vicar for?
She doesn't agree with the wording in the service.
Oh, for God's sake!
Paul, for heaven's sake!
For heaven's sake! It's the same service they've used for hundreds of years.
Well, could you just ask them to come outside to see her?
Oh, shall I come and see her?
No, it's bad luck for the groom to see the bride before the service.
I don't think you could persuade her anyway, Gerald. She's set on it.
Set on what, Gordon? I think I'll go and see what's happened.
No, no, you heard what Anna said. It's bad luck.
Well, it'll be worse luck if she's changed her mind.
I'm sure it won't come to that, Gerald.
This Mr. Edwards? What does he want shifting?
It's Mrs. Edwards, isn't it?
Says Mr. Edwards on the docket. Do you know what it is?
Nope. Tiger Lily's worth a few bob at Kempton.
I used to run my own van business once, you know.
What?
Yeah. The worst thing to shift with them pianos.
Yeah, well, I don't think it'll be a piano. Look, can you drop us off at the bookies? It's just up here on the right.
All right, how long will you be?
Don't panic. You wait. Look, it's only round the corner, so I'll shove this on. I'll meet you there. Pull up here, will you?
Listen. Don't you think it'd be best if I waited for you?
We don't want him ringing the boss moaning that we're late now, do we?
No. All right, but just hurry up, will you?
Love and cherish is all very well, but I'll not blindly obey any man, even if I do love him.
Mother, you're being silly. Hundreds, thousands of brides make these vows. I made them.
Oh, yes? And look what happened to you.
Yes, but,
I suppose you've been filling her up with these ideas.
No, she read it in a magazine at the hairdresser's.
Magazine? This is ridiculous.
It was a very sensible article. It made me think.
Oh, this is nonsense. Look, can we just get on with the service?
If I may just say... Thank you. If I may just say, it's quite acceptable for the word obey to be omitted from the marriage vows. Quite fashionable these days, in fact.
Well, there you are. There's no problem. I'm sorry about this, Vicar.
But I don't want it omitted.
But you just said you did.
I want it altered.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
I could just discuss the details with the vicar. If you don't mind.
Poor Gerald's going to be frantic.
Dawson's
good to see
Mr. Edwards.
Come in. Your boss said you'd be here at 5:30.
I know, sorry about that.
Mind you, not that it matters much.
No.
Come on.
All right.
He's not a small man, my husband.
Well, it's knowing the technique in this job, you know, having the experience. One wrong move, he can do you back in, just like that.
Oh, I can imagine. Are you in your own?
Well, my mate will be here in a minute.
He's in there. In bed.
But he's,
No, he's in his pyjamas. But I've had his good suit cleaned.
He's dead?
I wouldn't have believed it had been so quick if I hadn't seen it with my own eyes. One minute he sat up in bed with his cocoa and the echo. The next, gone.
Repeat after me. I, Myrna Winifred, take you, Gerald Mannering, to be my husband.
I, Myrna Winifred, take you, Gerald Mannering, to be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love, cherish, and and to be a faithful and cheerful companion in the twilight of our years, till death us do part.
To love and cherish and be a faithful and cheerful companion in the twilight of our years, till death us do part.
Give me the ring. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let this ring be to Mona and Gerald a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Place the ring on her finger. Say after me, I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage.
I give you this ring as a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
Going to think, eh? They'll think I can't afford a decent funeral. Here, get me at the end of that. Isn't it time your mate was here?
Yeah, and when he gets here, he's dead. Oh, look, I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. What, no, what I meant was...
Shh! I know what we'll do. Go and get me coat on, and Grandad will take you for a walk. That never fails.
Just mind the paintwork, that's all.
All right, all right. Oh, God. Come on, swing it round. Watch the banister.
Oh, are you doing all right then?
Yeah, how are you? Are you all right?
All right.
What are you doing here?
Been to see some fella about wedding invitations.
Come in.
This some kind of joke, is it?
Yeah, there's all kinds of scratches on this.
Well, is it?
Oh, come on, we'll do it to all the new drivers.
Oh, so that makes it all right, does it? Hey?
It's not all weddings and VIP visits, you know. It's only a laugh.
Oh, yeah, it's a laugh, isn't it, when she's gonna help me lug her up the stairs?
Don't worry. We'll take good care of him, love. Now, why don't you go and put the kettle on, eh?
Ah, what a job.
Well, someone's got to do it. And next time, it won't bother you.
Aye. No, I wouldn't be too sure about that.
Believe me, lad, you won't bat an eyelid. I wish he tucked his elbows in, though. Might have to crack them now.
What?
You're all right. All you have to do is ump coffins and drive. Right then, Arthur.
Jack, he's your best man. Tell him we want the vicar on this one.
Did you hear that? Using Grandad's name.
Which is a lot better, but she does still get confused.
Perhaps he should change his name. Did you know he was called Mannering?
What are you ringing for? Yes, I know, but I got a bit delayed, carrying Tim round the shop. We'll be leaving soon. Dad's just made some tea. As soon as we can. Yes, he's fine. Fine.
Run out of coffee at your house. Is that why he came?
Just thought I'd pop around. Don't know why.
You've wanted to come back here for a while, haven't you?
I don't think I should have done. You'll be ready for some kip now.
There's no need to rush off, Rod. I don't want to go to sleep yet.
No.
They're not in, mate. They've gone to a wedding.
Have you seen my dad, Harry Cross?
Well, he came out to show his grandson just before I went out.
Do you know where he went?
Well, I left him talking to Sheila.
Hi, Kevin.
Do you know where Dad went with the baby when he left you?
Yeah, home.
The house is empty. He was supposed to stay there.
Well, have you checked the neighbours? I mean, he's as pleased as punch with that baby.
There's no one in. I sound like a frantic if I don't get Tim home soon. She's not been too well.
Well, maybe we should drive around, see if he's gone for a walk or something.
He hasn't got the baby buggy. The carrycot's still in the house.
There you are. Safe and sound.
Poor Harry.
Making the rules, eh?
Where the hell have you been?
I took him for a walk. He was crying.
You've no right to go off like that. I was worried sick.
He was all right with me. I was careful.
Yeah, so careful you left the patio doors open.
I was only gone for 5 minutes. And after all, he is my grandson.
Just go and get the door open, will you, before he catches cold?
Kids, eh? Who'd have them?
Couldn't do without mine.
Yeah, no. I'm sorry about Tracy the other day.
There'll be a lot more than that before we finish, you know. Forget it, eh?
Yeah.
Well, he went for a walk.
You're still not very talkative.
Hmm.
You feeling guilty?
No.
Rod, I think I know what's wrong. It's all around the station, you know. How you volunteered to tell that woman who lost a bloke. Must have been hard.
Yeah.
It's no good bottling it all up. Do you want to talk about it?
No.
It might help, you know.
We've already talked about it. Sir Kirsty.
All this? I was trying to help you.
You have?
Oh, yeah? In what way?
I am here.
No! Go on, Rod. Have a help day.
You just have.
Has Kirsty lost interest, eh?
No.
Has she? See?
No, I mean, I don't know.
His nappy was filthy. He needed a drink. You can't take babies out just like that.
I'll change his nappy next time.
Next time? If Sal knew about this, there wouldn't be a next time. I've stuck my neck out for you, Dad, coming here and bringing him, and you've let me down.
I'm sorry, I didn't think.
Well, you've got to think. And I think we'll have to wait until he's a lot older before you can look after him.
Look, I'm his granddad, and I hardly know him. Your mother doesn't know him at all.
You're being ridiculous. Mum's dead.
I want to take him to that cemetery.
What?
I want to take him to the cemetery.
Cemetery? There's no place for a baby.
But what about Edna?
No. I'm not having you taking him to that cemetery. You can forget all that. I've got to go. And if Sal rings, don't you dare mention this.
I'm going for Claire.
Yeah, I'll give you a lift, all right?
OK, thanks. You're very quiet.
Do you know what day it is today?
Wednesday.
It's my 22nd wedding anniversary. Don't worry, I'm not getting down or anything like that. It's just that I've done something today I should have done ages ago. I went into town to see a solicitor. I'm going to divorce Doreen. I thought you'd be pleased about it.
Well, yeah, I am in a way. It's just...
Now, go on.
Oh, it doesn't matter. Are you right,
you silly man. Do I have to do everything for you? Look, I want these...
Arthur, surely you've got enough photographs now. Your car is waiting.
be wanting a picture of the driver next.
Don't you dare suggest it.
I forgot that hotel confirmation. I think we could give it to them now. Gerald, Mother, we'd like you to have this. It's the wedding present from Paul and me. Well, what is it?
The best room in the Windermere Terrace Hotel for tonight. Plus dinner and champagne.
Well, I'm sorry, dear, but we can't go.
What?
But it's all booked and paid for.
Well, I'm very sorry, but my husband and I are off to Vegas.
Where?
Las Vegas. America.
We're catching the 8 o'clock plane from Manchester for Heathrow.
But, Mother...
Look, I'm having a second honeymoon. Why don't you have one, too? You have the room in Windermere. Come on, Gerald, car's waiting.
Yes. Well, what do you think? Too expensive to waste.
What about Gordon?
Don't worry about me. Gran wants you to have a second honeymoon. Why not?
But it's so embarrassing. I mean, your father and I made the booking. I can't.
Of course you can.
I don't see why not.
Well, why not?
Come on, and we missed the send-off.
Coming up in Jimmy's, an update on tiny Gillian Peacock, who weighed just 2 pounds at birth. That's next.
I saw the car there. I thought Jonathan might be in.
Oh, no, I took him to the office this morning.
Will he be back around five, you know?
Well, he might be, but I doubt it. Can I help?
Well, it's something I wanted to ask Jonathan, a favour, like...
Well, come in. Maybe I can help.
Oh, yeah. Look, I'd come back later, only I'm on nights, and I've got to be in around five, you see.
Oh, well, can I give him a message?
Well, if you wouldn't mind, it'd be great, yeah?
Yeah, that's OK.
Well, it's about this friend of mine, a fella called Derek Rees. You know, I've known him for a few years and that, and, well, he's a good bloke, could do anything for you and everything, and he's got himself in a bit of trouble and he needs a solicitor.
Well, what kind of trouble's he in? Criminal?
Well, sort of, only the police aren't involved. Well, the thing is, like, he's been sacked and I don't think it's fair.
Well, doesn't the union handle that kind of thing?
We're not in a union.
Oh. So, what's he been dismissed for?
Well, he's supposed to have pinched some bacon, but he didn't.
I don't understand.
Well, he did take the bacon, like, but he didn't pinch it.
Oh.
No, it's not like that. Well, it's a bit of a long story, really.
And you'd rather tell it to Jonathan, right?
Well, I'd sooner he told it to Jonathan. It's a bit, you know, complicated.
Yeah, it's okay. Looks pretty black, though, hey?
It does, doesn't it?
Still, it seems a bit harsh to fire him. I mean, didn't you say you worked with him for a couple of years, so he's not exactly new to the firm?
Well, he's been there 19 years.
19 years?
Yeah.
That doesn't sound right.
Doesn't, does it?
Well, I think Jonathan'd be only too happy to help.
Oh, do you think so? That'd be great, that. I mean, he's been to see a few other solicitors, only they've all knocked him back. Said he wouldn't stand a chance in that.
Don't worry. You tell your friend he's got a solicitor who'll fight for him.
Oh, great. I'll tell him to get in touch then, eh?
OK, and I'll tell John to expect him.
Right. Thanks a lot.
My pleasure.
Ta-da.
Bye.
They've just ignored everything. I don't believe it.
All right, love, what's that?
It's from the Education Authority.
Hi, Jeff Stevens.
Yeah. They're admitting that he's got learning difficulties, but that is it.
They've always known he had learning difficulties.
Exactly. They're deliberately ignoring his dyslexia. They think that by not admitting it, it doesn't exist.
So it's all been a waste of time?
Oh, no, it hasn't. They might say that everything possible has been done, but we know that it isn't. I'm not going to take this, Frank.
What do you mean?
Well, we fight on. We're going to appeal.
Listen, Chris, you've already promised that, Jeff. You won't drag him through any more examinations and reports. You said that was it.
I know I did, love. But can't you see they're trying to do a whitewash job on in here? They are not going to ignore my son. He is not going to leave school at 16, not being able to read. And that is that.
Come on through, Mr. McMahon. You didn't tell me very much on the phone.
Oh, no. You never know who's listening.
Ah. I take it this is a delicate matter.
It is perfectly confidential. What goes on in here?
Completely.
You come recommended as a forward-thinking young man.
Well, I like to think so. Could I just ask you why you've come to me?
I told you. You come recommended.
But surely you already have a practice working for you.
Oh, Deadwood, all of them. They're living in the past. The business world out there is going so fast that they can't keep up with it. I need some advice from someone who understands corporate law and who can manipulate it to the best advantage.
Manipulate?
Well, no, not manipulate. Utilize. There's nothing shifty, underhand, that's all.
But there are problems to be overcome.
Well, of course there are. If it were all perfectly straightforward, I wouldn't need a smart lawyer, would I?
No.
I want to sell my company.
Excited.
Oh, yes, this is a little jigsaw. There you go. You look lovely.
All right. Hey, Jonathan's going to take on Derek's case, you know.
Oh, that's great. Now, doesn't she look lovely?
You look a cracker, don't you? Where are you going?
Philip's party.
Philip's party? Brilliant, yeah. Eh?
Have you brushed your teeth? Go and get them brushed. Off you go. Good scrub. That's good news about your friend.
I hope so. I think it's terrible what they're trying to do to him. He's not a tea leaf, you know.
I suppose supermarkets must get used to people trying to steal from them.
Yeah.
I was wondering whether to go to the auction on Wednesday. And I'm not sure whether I could bear to see strangers bidding for the old house.
I think it'd be better if you didn't go, you know.
Yeah, I suppose so. I wish I could just brush away all the memories like Bob seems to have done.
How is he?
He's okay. He's staying at Matty's till he's 100% fit. I feel a bit bad. I should have gone to see him, really.
Well, you shouldn't. You and him are finished now. You'll have to stop feeling responsible for him. Claire's here now, and so am I, all right?
Ready, Mummy.
Come on then, miss. Let's get going.
What have you lost?
I think I might have dropped some money down the side of the armchair.
Huh? Much?
I don't know. I only think I might.
You don't know.
Well, let me put it another way, Dad. I don't have a penny, and I'm hoping that in more pecunious times I might have dropped some down here.
I see. You've no money, so you've resorted to scavenging, eh?
I knew I could rely on you to sum it up in your usual considered way.
What do you want money for?
Need money for? Well, I suppose there's two reasons. One, I gave up my job voluntarily, so although I am signing on, I'm still not entitled to any dole yet. And two, it's Mum's birthday shortly, and I'd like to get her a present.
Look, you don't need to do that. I'll give you some money if it's to buy a present for your mother.
thanks, Dad. I hate not having money.
I don't understand you. You make a lot of money, then you gamble it all away. Whatever happened about doing something with your life? Or the new start you promised?
I'm going to make one.
I see no sign of it. All I see is the same old layabout Gordon. In bed half the morning, no attempt at getting a job. Better pull yourself together again. Get out and look for something useful to do.
I have something useful to do.
Lying in bed.
Look, Dad, if you could just lend me about £20, I'll pay you back in a week or two, all right?
£20?
Well, I need to get buses and things if I'm to be a useful member of society.
Oh, all right.
Just a loan. I'll pay you back.
Oh, fine. Just a loan.
And, Dad, I don't need you to tell me I've got to start all over again.
The new company isn't a direct competitor in that we manufacture electrical components and they're primarily involved in the casing side, so it's horizontal integration. Put the two together and you have a strong manufacturing company. Also, we are neatly placed. We're just outside a development corporation area and that can only be good for the future.
So why do you want to sell?
Well, I'm getting near retirement, Jonathan. It's a good offer. And there's a lucrative consultancy on the table.
What's holding you back?
I don't want my 200 staff to see me as the baddie in all this.
Why should they do that? Their jobs would be safe. Unless the new company are just asset stripping.
Oh, no, 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 no. It's my MD. He's a bit moral about it all. Wants to save the old name. That type. Now, he has 6% of the shares. Now, that's not really an obstacle. But he's talking about a management buyout. Of course, he couldn't possibly succeed. But it might just queer my pitch with a new firm.
I see. All right, well, time is on your side. I can handle the sale. That should be fairly straightforward. As for your troublesome MD, I suggest you keep a very close eye on everything he does. Check his trading record. There might be something there. And at the first sign of any impropriety, face him with it. Tell him to keep his head down until the deal goes through. He can decide whether he sells or tries to stay on in the new setup then.
They said you were a bright young man. I think we'll be doing a lot of business in the future if this goes smoothly.
I'd like that.
Pusey what? What does that mean?
Pusillanimous. It means small-minded and mean-spirited, and that's what these people are.
Are you sure about going ahead with this appeal?
Yes, I told you I was.
You're going to upset Jeff again.
Jeff's got to learn how to read. I'm not going to let these people wash their hands of him.
You can tell him then.
Oh, I will. And I don't expect much support from you either.
Hi, Dad. Mum. Me and Molly will go upstairs, all right?
Yeah.
Chris.
I was an old Appleton and painted it.
Oh, wait, you're not kidding. We went to France for our holidays last year and I loved it. But she makes French so boring now, Neville, ain't it?
I know. Wish we had Miss Murray for it. She's great.
She doesn't do French.
I know. I wish she did, though.
Hmm. So?
So what?
Oh, you know what, Erwin?
What about him?
Well, what? I mean, how's it going?
It's not. I'm too embarrassed to even talk to him since my dad threw him out.
Oh, wait, you shouldn't let that stop you. Do you still fancy him?
Yeah.
Well, then why don't you talk to him? I'm sure he fancies you.
I don't know. Anyway, I'm too embarrassed to talk to him with this on my teeth. It's horrible.
Oh, come on, you will, yeah?
No, I'm not talking to him till I get this off.
And when's that going to be?
I don't know. I've got a dentist appointment on Monday, but I don't know whether he's going to take it off or just tighten it up a bit.
Well, your teeth look great. He'll have to take it off.
I hope so.
So will you talk to Erwin?
If I get this off, yeah. I heard about a girl who was kissing a boyfriend goodnight when he got stuck on a brace and a dab come out, I'd die.
Oh, you can keep your mouth closed when you kiss him, you know. You don't have to French kiss all the time.
Hey, do you reckon old Appleton French kisses?
Only 3 more nights and you'll be back on days.
Yeah, I like my nights at home these days.
Oh, do you? I like your nights at home as well.
Do you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's good.
Oh, love's young dream.
What?
I say, love's young dream. And the music goes round and round.
What do you mean by that?
What? Love's young dream?
No, they're going round and round, but what are you trying to say?
I wasn't trying to say anything.
Yes, you were.
Simply passing the time of day.
Oh, it sounded like it to me.
I find your attitude rather offensive.
Oh, do you? And I find people who go around passing snide remarks about their neighbours offensive.
It wasn't passing snide remarks. I'm sure there'll be others who will. But I've more sense at your age, kissing in the street.
At our age? Listen, mate, people can fall in love at any age, even yours.
Billy, leave it.
Why?
Just leave it.
You can't go around telling people what to do.
Look, leave it. It's a touchy subject. I don't think he wants to talk about it.
What do you know about it?
What was all that about?
If I get my brace off on Monday, I will.
Supposing you don't, though?
Then I don't talk to him. I'm not being laughed at by him, Ronnie.
Oh, he won't. He's crazy about you.
Who said that?
Oh, everyone knows that. He's nuts about you. No fact, that.
I don't know.
Well, go on, you laugh too.
Why?
Well, because you fancy him and he fancies you.
And?
What do you mean, and?
Come on, there must be another reason. Or you wouldn't be going on about it so much.
I'm not going on about it. You're the one who's going on about it.
You're up to something, aren't you?
No.
Then why are you so keen for me to talk to Aaron?
Well, I just thought that if you were going out with Aaron, you could, you could ask him if he's made Pete free.
You scheming little cow, trying to get me off with him so you can cop off with Pete.
Or I wouldn't half be grateful. We could go out in a force and have a great laugh.
Might fancy him.
He does. I've seen him looking at me with that you know look.
Then why don't you give him that you know look back?
Oh, I couldn't. I'd be ashamed.
Oh, so you want me to do all your dirty work for you?
Oh, come on, you'll enjoy it. Anyway, you fancy Erwin.
Maybe. But I'm not talking to him till I get this brace off.
Hi! You get home. I wasn't coming for you till 7.
I got a cab. I thought I'd surprise you.
You certainly did.
I've had a good day. We got some great new business.
Hey, that's great, because I got you some business today, too.
More business?
Yay! Oh, God. I don't suppose it's worth a fortune, but every little bit helps.
How do you mean?
Well, actually, I didn't get it for you. It came here.
Here?
One of the neighbours, Billy Corkill.
Oh, yes. What troubles him now, then?
No, it's not him. It's a friend of his. He's been sacked for stealing a pack of bacon, and he wants somebody to represent him.
Oh, yeah, that's not really the sort of work I'm after.
Oh, I know. But you will do it, won't you?
No, I don't think so. No, it's more the corporate stuff we're looking for. This Peter McMahon's.
Yeah, but John, you've got to help this guy.
Well, his union will help him if he needs it.
No, but he's not in a union.
Well, then that's his fault. Anyway, the guy's probably guilty. He deserves to be sacked if he was caught stealing.
Jonathan, that is terrible. Don't prejudge.
Look, Cheryl, I just don't want the case, okay?
But I promised.
You promised? You promised. You've no right to do that. You've no right to promise me to anyone else.
John, you're being totally unreasonable about this.
Unreasonable? I think it's just a little bit unreasonable to commit me to a client at work without prior consultation.
But it's not a client. It's a neighbour. I mean, Billy Corkill came over here today to ask for your help. What can I say?
You shouldn't have said anything. You should have told him to come back later.
I promised.
Well, then you can just go and unpromise. I'm going upstairs for a shower.
Frank? Do you want these spuds boiled or mashed, love?
I don't mind. What's with them?
I thought we'd have a nice little bit of cabbage and custard with them.
Great, yeah. Not too much custard for me, though, eh?
So you're all listening, then?
Every word, my angel.
Mum? Oh, Mum, how Katie's messing about. She knows you want to talk. She just wants to listen in.
Well, if it's that interesting, perhaps me and your mum should listen as well.
Dad. All right, go and tell Katie she can come downstairs and help me with the tea, then.
Why did we buy this house, eh? It's just not big enough.
Because money doesn't grow on trees, my girl. Tell her, Frank.
Money doesn't grow on trees.
Frank!
I want to ask you something.
how many people know about you and Brian?
Just you and Gordon.
You sure?
I think so, yes.
What about Sheila Grant?
Sheila Grant?
She knows. She said something this morning, and I knew what she was thinking.
Perhaps.
But she knew.
Yes, probably.
How do you mean, probably?
She saw us together once. Haven't talked about it, but I think she guessed.
And how many others?
None that I know of.
But we don't know how many people Sheila Grant has told.
Sheila Grant isn't the sort to go gossiping around the close.
But she knows.
Does it matter now?
Yes, it matters.
I'm sorry.
Oh, come on, don't be like that. You just shouldn't promise what's not in your power to fulfill.
I thought you wouldn't want to be turning down any business just as you were starting out.
It was not that kind of business. Hours and hours of hard slog for a few legal aid pennies. No thanks.
Fortunately, your partner doesn't feel the same way.
Sarah?
I called her while you were in the shower. She'll handle it.
You called Sarah after I'd said no?
You said no, she said yes. She'll handle it. You don't have to dirty your little hands with anything so small and mundane.
You should not have done that. You should not have gone behind my back. You know how I feel about this.
I didn't know you felt anything about it. I thought you were totally immune to anything that didn't have a share issue.
It's not our branch of law.
Yeah, but you could have done it. I mean, you said yourself that you'd probably have to take some cases you didn't want until you got yourselves established.
Not criminal cases.
It's not a criminal case.
I don't want to argue with you.
Don't then. Let's just forget that I ever mentioned Billy Corkill's friend to you. Sarah will sort him out and that will be that.
You just shouldn't get involved with work this close to home. Neighbours can be a pain.
I know. I kind of like Billy, though.
So that's why you wanted to work at home today, was it?
Home? This doesn't feel like home. It's all so complicated here now.
Yeah, it'll be all right.
I know. I just need to get away for a while. Hey, how do you feel about going back over to Canada for the summer?
Oh, Cheryl, how can I? The business is getting off to a great start, but I still need to be there to keep it that way.
Not even 2 weeks?
We could probably manage a weekend in the lakes.
Oh, but John, I'm gonna go mad if I'm cooped up any longer in this place.
Well, it was you who wanted to stay here and study.
I don't mean that. It's this house. It's not big enough for four adults. And when the baby comes, it is going to be impossible.
Yes.
Why don't you let me just go and look for somewhere else for us to live? Then we could move into a decent-sized place.
Oh, okay, have a look. But don't go buying anything without me.
As if I would.
Smells good, Mum.
Miriam gave me the recipe.
You've become quite friendly with Miriam lately, haven't you?
Yes. Funny, isn't it? You lose touch with somebody and then when you meet up with them again, it's as though you've never been away.
Well, it must be nice to have someone to share your secrets with.
I haven't got any secrets, Paul. If I had, I would tell you.
Come on now, let's not start having an argument over who's friendly with who and why.
I wasn't aware that we were.
Well, it sounded like it.
Well, it wasn't.
Good.
Your father is looking for an argument. And as he can't find one with me, he's looking to you. So just ignore him.
Well, that's what everyone else does, anyway.
Ooh, we're into the self-pitying bit now, are we?
I am not pitying myself.
This is ridiculous. I don't think I can stand any more of you two fighting like this.
You can't stand it.
I'm going out.
Out?
Yes, out. And don't expect me back tonight.
Why? Where are you going?
Does it matter?
Gordon?
Well, what was all that about?
I don't know.
Where can he be going if he's going to be out all night?
I don't know.
He hasn't got any money. Go after him.
What for?
To stop him.
Stop him doing what?
I don't know. He could be going anywhere.
I know.
Follow the first ever footage of the Royal College of Surgeons examinations in today's Jimmies.
Tea, love.
Hiya, I thought you were supposed to be at work.
I was, but I've got something to do and we're not busy until tomorrow. So Tommy Yates is covering for me.
Fine, thanks, I'd love a cup.
Where have you been?
I've been to see Mrs. Allison, you know, from the Dyslexia Society.
Oh.
Well, she's been filling me on things I'll need for the appeal. You know, school reports, that sort of thing. I was thinking of ringing Bangor, see if Dr. Medley would appear as a witness for us.
Why don't you just leave it alone, eh?
Because I can't. I can't just lie down, Frank, and let them walk all over me.
You. That's it, isn't it? You won't let them walk all over you. No mention of our Jeff.
It's Jeff I'm doing it for.
He doesn't want you to do anything. The more fuss you make of it, Chris, the more upset he gets.
You'll thank me in the long run.
I hope you're right, Chris. Because if you're not, he's going to hate you for it.
Ah. No sign of him yet?
Nope. Two nights. Why doesn't he phone?
That's the least he could do.
Do you suppose he's gone cruising? That's what they call it.
They call it cruising.
I thought he might have gone gambling again, but he hasn't got any money.
He had a little. Not enough to go gambling.
Didn't have any at all the other day.
I gave him some.
Why don't we just trust him? Why don't we support him when he needs it?
I'd be quite willing to support him, but he isn't here.
If we don't support him, Paul, we're going to lose him for good.
That's a two-way relationship. You must start considering us as well. Staying out for two nights without letting us know where he is or what he's doing is hardly considering us or our feelings.
Maybe not. But the first trusting and support's got to come from us.
Well, when he comes back, we'll try a new start.
Please, come in, Mr. Race. If you'd like to take a seat.
Thank you.
Right, now, I have just a few details passed to me
via a Mr. Billy Corkhill.
Billy Corkhill, yeah, he's been helping me, like. Good bloke, Billy.
Yes, yes, he seems it. Right. How long have you been with the company?
Nearly 20 years. I went there when I was made redundant at Capenhurst. Yeah, 20 years in August.
Uh-huh. And you haven't had any other trouble with the company?
No. We had a bit of an argument about overtime payments, like, but that was 6 years ago.
But nothing else?
No. I'm a good worker. I work hard. They've never had any complaints. That's what I don't understand.
What time was it exactly when you took the bacon?
About 8. No, just after, because we finished at 8. And I went back to get the bacon. I promised the wife, like. I left the money, at least I left a pound, on the till. The bacon was only 89 pence. What I didn't know was that the security camera had seen me take the bacon, but hadn't seen me put the money down.
Oh. All right.
Yes.
So?
So what?
So what did you want to talk to me about?
Me?
Yeah, you wanted to talk to me about something, didn't you?
I'd love to have talked to a lad again. It wouldn't work the second time.
So you don't want to talk to me then?
Why should I?
Well, Ronnie said you did.
Ronnie? Crafty little cow.
Oh, look, if you don't want to talk to me, I'll get off, shall I?
Oh, no, wait, look. I'm sorry. I thought you were trying one of your chocolate tricks again.
So, you do want to talk to me then?
Well, in a way, yeah. Well, it's Ronnie who wants me to talk to you. She fancies your mate Pete and she wants you to tell him.
Pete, eh? Sound, yeah? He fancies her too.
Oh, good. Maybe she'll stop pestering me now.
Well, what are you doing for dinner, then?
Well, supposed to be going down the pre-date with Ronnie, but she's conveniently disappeared. You can come if you want.
Oh, sound, yeah. Takes up the two lovebirds, then, eh?
After my fixing for her, it's up to your mate now to ask her out.
Oh, right, little stickler for protocol, aren't we? One step at a time, eh? Now, what clothes should he be wearing when he has to take her out? I know, has he got to ask her out, fella, first, if he can take her out?
I think you've cracked.
I think I must have to still be here with you, actually.
Then I was called into the boss's office.
That's your boss, not the supermarket boss?
Yeah. He said the supermarket had seen me taking the bacon on the video and that he had no alternative but to sack me.
Well, did you tell him about leaving the coin?
Too right. He rang them up at the supermarket and they looked at the video again and said they couldn't see that part of the shop, but they'd ask if any of the girls had picked it up.
But none had?
No. I waited outside the boss's office for over 2 hours, hoping somebody had found it, but no. I never felt so bad in my life. I've never stolen a thing in my life, Miss Townes. I wasn't even thinking of pension when I went home. All I could think about was how I was going to tell the wife that I'd been sacked for thieving. I've got 4 grown-up kids, 9 grandchildren. How could I tell them? I need your help, Miss Townes. I've got to prove that I'm no tea-leaf. Will you help me?
We don't normally handle this sort of thing. We're more accustomed to takeovers, mergers, contractual stuff. However, I don't like seeing honest men branded as thieves while the real thieves get away with the loot.
I'm sorry, I don't understand you. What loot?
Your pension, Mr. Reese. How long do you have to go before retirement? It looks like your company's trying to get out of paying your full pension. 19 years and no fair hearing? I'll be delighted to represent you.
Do you want to come in?
Yes, thank you.
Do you want to sit down?
Yes, thank you.
Would you like a cup of tea?
Oh, no.
Look, Paul, it was a silly argument. Billy's on nights and he doesn't like leaving us.
I wasn't thinking about Billy. It was something you said.
Me?
Yes, about a touchy subject. You knew about Anna and Brian, didn't you?
Yes. Annabelle didn't tell me, you know. I just happened to see them together once.
Did you know it was all over now?
No, I didn't. I'm glad.
So am I.
Are you going to be all right?
I don't know. I still feel so much pain that I don't think I can ever totally forgive her. You see, I still love her.
I can see that. Do you not think that one day you might be able to forgive her?
I don't know. I want to. The hurt won't let me. This feeling of betrayal, it eats inside you.
Do you not think that might be because you're a little bit jealous?
Oh, no. No, I can't be jealous. She's not with him, she's with me. She's chosen me. No, it's not jealousy. It's the humiliation of it. Yesterday, when I realized that you knew, I thought, I can't hold my head up around here because everybody knows that my wife has been unfaithful to me. They'd be laughing at me or pitying me. And I don't want either.
Paul, that's not true. I mean, I felt sympathy for you, but I didn't feel pity. I certainly wasn't laughing at you.
Maybe not you. What about the rest?
I don't know if anybody else knows. I certainly haven't told anybody.
Not even Billy?
No, not even Billy.
Oh, thank you for that.
Paul, I can't condone what she's done, but I can't really condemn her either. I don't think you should, you know. I don't think we should judge each other. Look, I mean, you say you still love her. Well, can't you show her how much you love her by just forgetting what's happened? I'm sure she wants you to.
Oh, it's not that easy to forget. I'm happy to forgive her in time, but I doubt I'll ever be able to forget it.
Okay, well, why don't you just settle for forgive?
Well, I'll settle for that if I can get there.
I'm sure you will.
Thanks. You don't realize what it's like to be able to talk to somebody about it. Pain of it all, I've held it all inside.
What's up with your ma?
Nothing.
If I talked to my ma like that, she'd crack me.
Yeah, well, your ma isn't giving you all kinds of hassle, is she?
Why? What's she doing now?
She's appealing against what the school said.
What does that mean?
She's just doing it to embarrass me.
Yeah, but if it means you get to read, it'd be worth it, won't it?
I don't know. Don't know why she can't teach me.
She's tried, remember?
Yeah, well, I don't want to go through all that again. You know, all the hassle and that, asking the questions, makes you feel so you're not right in the
end. Well, then tell them you are. Tell them that you're going to play for Liverpool Boys. You can't be backward if you do that, can you?
Look, they're not interested in that. It's just all these exams that they worry about.
Hey, I wish you'd let me know when you're coming home at dinner time. Corned beef and piccalilli, that's all I've got.
So, Mrs. Rogers. Jeff says you're going to appeal against this school report.
Yeah. Well, I wish he'd realise it's for the best.
That's what I said.
Want something to drink?
You got any milk?
I'll go and have a look. Jeff?
Milk.
Please?
Please. Hugh was no help.
There's nothing I can do.
You can stop agreeing with her. She doesn't need any encouragement from you.
No, I'm sorry, but she's all right, your ma. And she makes great butties.
Yeah. She's thinking of sending me to some school on the Whittle every Saturday morning.
Saturday morning? But you play footy on a Saturday morning?
Yeah, I don't have to pack it in if she sends me there.
But you can't do that. You're our best player. The team needs you. All right, she's going too far with that. We've got to stop her.
She agree with me now?
She can't do it. It's selfish. She's not thinking about the team.
I wish there was somewhere we could phone.
No idea where he is. How can we phone?
No right to put us through this.
Let's wait till he comes back. See what he has to say.
I'm worried about him.
And so am I.
Hiya.
Where have you been?
I don't suppose there's any more of that, is there? I could just do with a bowl of soup.
Yes, I'll get you some.
Where have you been?
Just out.
Just out? Anywhere in particular?
Here and there.
Gordon, you've been away for 2 nights. Your mother and I have been worried sick about you, and all you can say is here and there.
I told you I wouldn't be home Monday night.
Yes, but you didn't tell us where you were going.
Must I tell you everything about my life?
No, but we do worry about you when you stay out.
Would you be so worried if I'd spent the night with a girlfriend?
Yes, of course we would.
It would be different, but not all that different.
Yes, it would.
We're not ashamed of you, but we are concerned about you. You've already had one scare.
It's when you go off without saying where you're going and then not telling us when you come back.
All right, I'll tell you. I've been making myself a useful member of society by doing some voluntary work.
Oh?
What kind of voluntary work?
I've been helping with the night shift on the AIDS helpline, and I'm thinking of training to do it regularly. It's pretty bloody harrowing, I can tell you.
I can imagine.
So I don't know what you two thought I was up to, but I'm sorry if I disappointed you.
You've not disappointed us in what you were doing, but you have in the way you did it.
How do you mean?
It's all well and good helping others get over their traumas, but it's all rather negated when you put your own parents into a trauma through your selfishness.
Selfishness?
Yes. You told us you'd be away on Monday night, even though you didn't tell us why. But you've been away for 2 nights, and you hadn't the decency to phone us up and let us know you were all right.
I didn't phone because of where I was, Dad. I was at the gay centre, and you don't want to know about that side of my life, do you?
On Living It Up today, we'll be going traditionally Tudor when design journalist Sian Rhys shows us how to make our own ye olde fashioned scented soap balls.
Beauty artist of the stars, Shay Dixon, will be giving us some insider tips to making your mark when making up.
And supermodel mum turned successful model in her own right, Valerie Campbell, will be telling us what she likes to wear and when.
That's Living It Up at 2:55 today.
What are we going to do? Don't know. I just wish my mum would shut up about all this appeal stuff and that.
Never mind the appeal, it's this special school business we've got to stop. If I tell the lads in a footy team, they'll go mad.
Please, don't remind me. I'll never speak to her again if she makes me go through with this and stops me footy.
I'll have to round the others up, get together and do something.
Like what?
I don't know, do I? Kidnap your ma.
Shut up, you divvy.
Well, you think of something then.
I'm trying to, I just wish you'd shut up and let me think.
So, we're mates again then, eh?
Yeah, if you like.
I like.
What about your mate, Pete?
What about him?
Do you reckon he'll last for any else?
Oh, yeah, no sweat. He'll be buzzing when I tell him she fancies him. He's been after it for ages, you know.
Maybe we could all go out together to a disco or something.
What, just the four of us, like?
Yeah.
Sound, yeah. So your old fella's not coming?
Oh, shut up, Pete. I'm so ashamed. I nearly died.
Hey, I'll tell you what.
What?
If I promise to come to the disco with you,
yeah,
you'll have to promise to do me something.
What? Oh, look, it's about my bracelet to get it off on Monday.
No, not that, not that. The other way you got Ronnie fixed up with Pete.
Yeah.
You got to get me boxed off at Mrs. Twist.
Yeah.
be selling under the standard terms of sale by auction, copies of which we'll find hung at various places around the sale room. We've got three properties to sell today, so let's get straight on with it, shall we? Property number one, 23 Sandy Lane, McGarth.
Frank! Frank? Frank, is that you, love? Frank?
I think he's gone out, Mum.
What are you still doing here? Get down here now. It has gone 2 o'clock. What are you doing here when you should be at school?
We didn't know the time, Mum, honest.
Well, you get going and now.
If we go in this late, we'll be in trouble.
You'll be in bigger trouble if you don't. Now, go on, get. Go on. I'll be phoning that school in 15 minutes' time, and if you aren't there, mega trouble.
£32,000 going once, going twice, sold to the gentleman at the sign here. Ah, an unusual one next. We don't get many newish houses. In fact, it's the first I've done for about 3 years. 5 Brookside Close. A substantial detached house in a quiet cul-de-sac. 4 spacious bedrooms, bathroom, large living room. The whole recently decorated. Delightful gardens, front and rear. Now, who's going to start the bidding? 50,000, anyone? 50? 50,000 pounds. Come on, 50,000 pounds. All right, let's start at 40,000 then. 40,000 pounds. Do I see 40,000 pounds? No, I don't. All right, 30,000 then. £30,000. Come on, it's a big house, this. You couldn't get a council house for that. £30,000. Thank you, sir. 35, then. 35. 35. Come along, £35,000. 33, then. 33,000. 34. Up to you, sir. 34. 35 anywhere? No, sir? 35 or no? 35 or no? Gentleman's bid at 34,000. 35 or no? 35 or no? Going at 34,000. Going at 34,000 pounds. 35 I have. 36 or no? 36. 36 I have. 37, sir? 37,000 I have. Up to you, sir. 38 or no? 38 or no? 37,000 going once. Sold to the gentleman at the back, £43,000.
Are you all right, Bobby?
Yes, darling, of course I'm all right. It'd be better if you gave me a kiss. Give me a kiss.
Look, Dad, I have to know that you'll support me when bigoted morons like that bloke Mum brought to dinner start giving out all their prejudiced bile. I just need to know I can count on you.
It's a little awkward for us all.
Yeah, I know, but... Well, a little awkwardness, it shouldn't be able to break any bond of trust between us. By keeping silent while he was going on about Puffs and Blacks. You betrayed me. You betrayed my trust.
Yes, I think I did. Oh, we both did, your mother and I. All I can say is that I'm sorry and I hope it won't happen again. We both had a long chat about it and we're ashamed that we didn't speak up. It's convenient not to. So we didn't.
Thanks.
What for?
Just for admitting it. At least it seems we're getting on the same wavelength.
Hi, love.
Where have you been? I thought you had something to do this afternoon.
I did. Huh? Don't you want to know what it was?
Well, I suppose if you want to tell me, you will. Hey!
Chris, will you listen to me?
Looks like I'll have to now.
Right. I've been to the auction for the Grant's house.
Oh, yeah. Did you see who bought it?
Yeah, I did.
Anyone we knew?
Yeah. Us.
Us?
Us. I bought it.
Oh, my God.
Next today, the doctors work to get young Marouf fighting fit for a second kidney transplant in Jimmy's.
Oh, I want to ask you something, John. There was a light on in that house last night, so I went in to investigate.
It's very public spirit of you, Harry.
And Frank Rogers was there with a pasteboard and rolls of wallpaper.
Well, if he wants to decorate, I can't see what's the problem.
So you're telling me that's legal, and they have an exchange contract?
Well, I think these things can be arranged, yes. Yes, ask him if it bothers you.
Oh, you're only thinking you're a lawyer, eh?
Well, it's a while since I've done any conveyancing on a property that size. Good morning.
And do I have to move the box out of the room?
No, the decorator can handle that. Just leave it in the middle, he'd put a sheet over the top.
Well, it's madness, Frank. Why you had to agree to this?
You've got to pack up anyway.
Yeah, but he's their decorator, not ours. They should have the hassle, not us.
Well, I'll tell you how he put it, shall I? He's moving in with a little kid. He wants to get her room out of the way so she doesn't have to sleep in the fumes from the fresh paint.
How much more? You're too soft, you are.
But in a worry, Chris, the same as us. I mean, we've got access to the grant, so we can sort that out.
Yeah, well, all the houses that we handle at work, this has to wait until after completion.
At least it shows the serious, no thought of pulling out.
I have.
You don't mean that?
Well, I woke up at 3:30 this morning thinking about that bridging loan. I think we must be crazy.
But that's why it matters, Chris, to push things through. Never mind what's usually done.
On the phone!
Do you want me to ask to do more hours at work?
We'll see.
It's important, the phone.
I bet that's Jeff forgot what he needs for school.
Is this man called Bovril on the phone?
Oh, it'll be Mr. Bottrell, Jeff's primary teacher. I bet this means he's going to help us.
I'm going now, Dad. Wish me luck.
I thought your exams weren't until next week.
Not the exams. The dentist. Find out whether my brace can come off today.
Oh, good luck, love. Do you want lift in?
Aren't you at work today?
Nah, change your pattern. I'm doing some long runs with some overnights.
What for?
Because of the overtime, love. We're going to need every penny.
They must have got a fair price for their house. It's the only way they could possibly afford it.
They're doing the move on the cheap. He's even asked Gordon to help with the furniture.
Oh, I think I might join in myself.
You're not looking for moths, I hope.
I'm just working out if I ought to buy you a new dress.
Oh, well, that's lovely. Why?
Oh, Annabelle.
No, seriously.
It's your birthday. You'll be...
I know how old I'll be. I'm doing my best to put it behind me.
Well, I think we should celebrate. I think we've a good reason.
Do you? After this last year?
A new year started, Anna.
putting the old one far behind us. The old one is dead and buried.
Yes.
Believe me, we deserve a celebration.
All right. What have you got in mind?
Well, thought I might take you out for dinner, as I've always done. Your birthday wouldn't be the same if we didn't go out for a meal somewhere.
How true.
Well, you do want to, don't you?
It's whatever appeals to you.
That newspaper's downstairs, not brewed up.
Thank you.
If you're doing the helpline, shouldn't you get some rest?
Trouble with Dad?
He's planning my birthday celebrations. A meal out? It's just that we view the past year so differently. He's glad it's over and I'm... Well, I'm saying goodbye to something I'll never have again.
But it is gone.
Oh, yes. Don't worry. But when your father says the past is buried...
He's right.
He's right. But it doesn't get buried out there somewhere. It gets buried much closer to home.
Gets buried in your own head, Mum. In your heart. I had a pretty rough year too, you know. Got dumped myself. Or doesn't Christopher count?
Oh, come on, Gordon. I mean, Brian didn't dump me.
Well, he didn't exactly put up a fight.
You weren't there, so you've no right to say a thing like that.
I saw enough to get a pretty fair impression, Mum. So whenever you feel like getting sentimental, just remind yourself of how it ended, eh?
It's all fairly new to you, but you see, the layout has got to be right. You see, there's a way of doing these things which is...
Mr. Reese, good morning.
Sarah.
Sorry, it won't be a minute.
Problems.
Well, we'll talk about that later. Anyway, I think you're wanted.
Good morning. Very nice to see you. Come this way, please.
I'm sorry to keep you waiting, Mr. Reese.
You wouldn't think he needed help.
Oh, don't be misled. It's a manner, that's all. He wants something, you can be sure of that. Look, I know how down you feel. I wish I could give you some instant good news, but I can't, I'm afraid. I've been down to the supermarket and I've seen the manager there. He knows you took the bacon and left the pound coin at the till, and that we need proof it was found in the morning.
Does he know what I stand to lose?
Yes, I made that very clear. He explained it all to the checkout girls. But no one picked up any money in the morning.
Did you question the girls yourself?
Yes, I did. And I have to say, I don't think any of them were lying.
What does that mean? You think I am?
No, no, of course not. That's the last thing I think. It's just that I've drawn a blank so far and it's not going to be easy. Well, no witness when you put the money down is one thing, but no sign of it in the morning, well...
Oh, any one of them girls could have took that pound. Will they say it in front of a manager?
They will if they feel for you enough.
Oh, a packet of bacon worth 80 pence against a decent pension.
Don't worry, that did get across. They suggested I talk to the cleaners.
It's worth a try.
Yes, it is. But unless I can come up with something concrete, your employers aren't going to budge.
Have a word with you.
Harry, over here. Talk to the jockey, not the horse. What do you want to know, mate?
Is he working for you?
What makes you think that, Harry?
Maybe it's so you can get a sale because you let the house run down so much.
Harry, you were the landlord for long enough, and if that place is in bad nick, I think it's down to you, mate.
Oh, you're going to rent it, aren't you? That's why you're so cocksure of yourself.
Let's just say there'll be people moving in, Harry, and you're going to be made up. Is what you've always dreamed of, is what you've always wanted in that house.
What?
A doctor. Not a brain surgeon, perhaps, but a doctor all the same.
Oh, like the last one, eh?
And who knows, Harry? He might even keep snakes or grow grass in the living room like you thought we did.
Look, you've overstretched yourself. And if you have, it serves you right. And don't expect any tears from me.
Hello,
Gran? Doing here?
Hannah,
what have I?
Hannah, come quick.
Well, we've just come back from our honeymoon in Las Vegas, you silly boy.
But you live in Kendall, Gran.
I know. But we had to have the damp course finished. And until it's finished, we're staying here with you.
Well, Mum never said anything to me.
Howdy.
He rented the Roth House.
Okay?
They're lying down on our bed, so don't disturb them.
Bet they'll have dropped off by now.
And Gordon's resting too, thank goodness.
Gerald can have his bed tonight.
And the nights after that?
Oh, don't worry. It's all arranged. Gerald's going to buy a folding bed. They didn't lose all their money. They returned with some winnings, believe it or not. The bed will come out of that.
And they'll leave it here. And then they can land on us at will, without a word of warning.
Oh, come on now. It'll be fun to hear all their adventures. Apart from being a bit tired, they're in tip-top form.
Well, they've had an exciting time. They've been to America, haven't they? I'd probably feel the same in their position.
Well, we can have a holiday soon. Go up to the lakes, land on them. How about that, eh?
They'll all want feeding soon.
Anna?
Am I meant to be reading this?
If you want to, yes. The point is, it came by second post, but it didn't arrive on my desk until after lunch. And it's a letter from Peter McMahon. I mean, the girl is hopeless. I know she's got a cold, but she is hopeless.
Dirty tricks department worked, I see.
That's a little bit over the top.
Well, he says that the MD's backed down. I imagine that means he's been compromised.
I helped him to find a little leverage, that's all. I did the job I was asked to do.
And what now, McMahon can sell the firm?
I'll know more later on. I have to phone, but yes, I think it's looking good.
Good for McMahon.
He's paying me.
And his managing director, I wonder how he feels.
That's none of my business, Sarah.
No, fair enough. He's only the MD, hasn't even got a name. You don't even get to see his face. Still, what did you come to say to me?
Yes, our Wunderkind out there missed 60 words a minute. I've given her tomorrow off. Gives her a chance to nurse her cold and we can sort the paperwork out.
I hope that does mean we. Do you want to lift back tonight?
I thought your car was in for a service.
No, that's Wednesday. Cheryl rang and said she's going to be stuck in Manchester. She phoned earlier when you were out.
And you put your heads together and organised me without so much as a buy your leave?
You can talk. You're the one giving our secretary the day off.
One day isn't going to matter.
I don't know. Whenever she feels just the slightest bit off, she won't bother to come in.
Sarah, the world is full of girls who take the odd day off and give damn good service the rest of the time. It's probably the norm. It's the likes of us who are workaholics. Now what?
Oh, no, you're probably right. You've just given me a good idea. I've got a phone call to make, if you don't mind.
Me too.
Curtains, Chris, for the fourth bedroom. Don't forget.
Oh, this isn't a list about the house, love.
What is it, then?
Well, it's what we need in the way of food, what the kids are going to need for school next week, and what I need to do about Jeff's appeal, like seeing his teacher on Saturday, for instance.
Add curtains.
Did I unpack that mince?
Sit down and get your tea.
Did I even buy the mince? God!
Leave it.
Oh, no, it all goes brown and stale, and then I think I could poison you all.
It's them.
Oh, Frankie's gone and left a paint pot in the sink.
I'll take it out.
Oh, the bin's full of rubbish.
Hi, love.
Hiya.
Oh. Hey, turn it off.
Take it upstairs.
I thought you were doing your homework upstairs.
Yeah.
But that noise.
I've told you 100 times before I can't think without music.
Sam?
She won't answer. She's got a cob on.
Why?
The dentist said 2 more weeks for the brace and she's got this disc on Wednesday and I said she won't go.
Frank, I've just done a terrible thing.
The brace.
She hasn't had it off.
I didn't notice it myself.
Exactly, neither of us did.
Sorry, my tea break is over.
Frank! Thanks.
And on only the second night, Gerald almost won a motor car.
Almost? Mm,
within a whisker. Mind you, I didn't much care for the car. What kind of car was it, Gerald?
Oh, only a Mercedes. Gordon. Oh,
thanks, Gerald. Thanks, Grant.
Anna next. Yeah. How have you been keeping, Anna?
Mother, you can see I'm well. Tell us more. You've hardly started.
Oh, I told you all about it in the postcards. Loads.
Well, you may have written loads of postcards, but we certainly didn't receive any.
Oh, thanks, Gran. Gerald, that's great. Thanks.
Yeah. Well, we like the design of it. What do you think?
Very nice.
Oh, then we went to a concert. Do you remember that concert, Gerald? Yes. It was someone quite famous, can't quite remember who it was. Anyway, he had this friend who died of AIDS, and he told us about it. Then he sang this song in memory of his dear friend. It was very moving.
Not a very jolly reminiscence?
Paula, I think that was the front door. Annabelle, with our love and thanks for arranging a marvellous wedding.
Paul really
yes,
did
Yes, Paul did the arranging. You could tell it was Paul and not Teddy.
What do you mean by that?
Come on, Mum, open your present.
Oh.
You can see the Red Indian influence.
Right, thanks very much.
Yes, indeed.
Right. Well, but isn't Mr. Harry cross? What a pleasant surprise.
I didn't want to come in, really. It's not the moment.
Not at all. The more the merrier. Sit down. We've just got back from our honeymoon in Las Vegas.
Congratulations.
We liked it. Go and see for yourself. You're never too old.
Oh, well, I've got commitments here. I've got a grandson now, you know.
So have I. Gordon, would you like to go to Las Vegas?
Sure, it would suit Gordon down to the ground.
Gambling? Surely he's far too cautious.
You don't know him, Gerald.
Mum?
Oh, come on, you can't stop there, Anna.
Gordon staked £2,000.
It was nothing to do with gambling, Mum. Not in the sense they mean.
It's a terrible evil. My wife was prone to it, God rest her soul.
Honestly, Mum, you've got no idea. I'll speak to you later, Gran.
Well, Gerald, what about me? Aren't I to get a present as well?
Oh, didn't I say? Oh, yes. There we are.
Oh, but isn't this yours?
Oh, no. I wore it through customs, that's all. Oh. Simply the safest means of transportation.
Thank you. I'll just go and find somewhere safe for it now, then.
No, put it on before you go. Mr. Cross finds you amusing, Paul. We'll have to find him a present.
Oh, I only came in to ask a question, really.
Well, excuse me.
Gerald, why don't you give him Anna's present? I can see by her face she hates it.
No, not at all.
Excuse me. I was just wondering, have you heard anything about who's moving in next door? Rogers reckons he's going to rent it, but I can't see that it's not sold.
But does it matter?
Matters a lot to me.
This is going spare.
Oh, give the man a T-shirt. Yes, let him see there's a wider world than his next-door neighbour.
Heidi.
What's up?
Oh, it's just so typical of Mum, Dad. I mean, she'll sound off about me in there in front of Gerald and Harry, and her colleague makes remarks about gays. Offensive by anyone's standards, and you don't hear a peep out of her.
She's in a funny mood. I mentioned her birthday to her before.
Oh, I know about that. It's naff idea about taking her out to dinner.
Naff?
Well, it's hardly a big treat, is it? It's not exactly extra special.
It's the thought of her being just with me. It'd be all right if the rest of her friends were there.
Well, why not? Isn't that what birthday parties are all about?
Do you think she'd like one?
Yeah, I do. Especially if it was a surprise.
I think you've got something there, Gordon.
Mind you, do you know any of her friends now? I mean, most of them are on the bench, aren't they?
No. No, old friends, Sonia and Miriam, of course.
Oh, she'd help. She'd know who we should ask anyway.
She might well suggest Brian Lawrence.
Well, she wouldn't, Dad, would she? She knew. She'd have too much tact.
I put that hat on in there before. Caught Harry Cross smiling at me. Felt as though I was wearing cuckold's horns.
Oh, he doesn't know. No one on the close knows.
Sheila Grant?
She doesn't.
Yes?
I'm sorry, Dad. She won't say anything, surely.
No, she hasn't. I can't help feeling every time I turn the corner into the close, there'll be someone who knows. Someone who's laughing at me. I think maybe we should move from here.
Well, that's no answer, Dad. Now, give her a party. You make it work.
Not the party or the marriage?
Both.
They can go without me. I don't mind.
I know what you're really worried about.
You know nothing. You're too young.
It's snogging with that brace in your mouth.
Look, Katie, get out, will you?
Hey, what's going on here?
She had the brace when I fancied her, and he did all the stupid things to get her to go out. So why should she start minding now?
Oh, thank you, Clarina. Now hop it.
Besides, Mary Fletcher's got a brace, and she goes around grinning all the time, because it's in fashion. I mean, I wouldn't mind a brace.
Perhaps you'd like your jaw wired up as well.
I just thought she was going to take it off today, that's all.
Well, I think your fella's quite fit myself. And if I were you, and I didn't go to the disco, I'd be worried that somebody'd take him off me. Ronnie, for instance.
Well, she'll have peace.
I've been caught out like that. Doesn't always follow.
I just wanted it to be perfect, Mum. Like the best night out ever.
Well, it'll help if you're there, of course.
Congratulations, Jonathan. Our first success. We're on our way.
Remember the Phillipson account? The way that looked so good at first?
Am I counting the chickens before they've hatched? No. Mr. McMahon is pleased with me. He wants to recognise my skill and care.
Slush money?
Don't be silly.
He's paying you a nice lump sum, then?
Oh, much better than that. He'll have a word with the guy who's bought him out, explain the service that I've done, etc., etc.
And?
And the upshot could be that I'll be offered shares. Shares in the company. Non-voting shares, of course.
In your name?
No, in our name, in the name of the firm.
But if they're in our name, then I'd be involved.
Well, of course you would. We're a partnership.
And you raised no objection?
No, I threw the idea back at him. Of course I raised no objection.
Well, you might have asked me first.
It hardly seemed wise to hum and haw.
All the same, Jonathan.
What's up?
I think we should start the way we mean to go on. Dealing with our own work in our own way, but discussing the things that affect us as a whole.
Right. OK. Right, well, it's just an idea as yet. Yeah. It was on the end of the phone, you know. Apologies.
And the temp? Bit lordly, really, giving her the day off.
We shall clear her paperwork first thing.
Sorry, I won't be in first thing. I have an appointment.
Fine, make the appointment later.
No. I'm seeing a checkout girl, and I don't want to cut into a working time if I can help it.
The supermarket again.
Yes.
You were there just the other day.
This particular girl was ill that day. You gave me the clue, and when I checked, I found she was someone I'd missed.
But the other girls will have told her that you were there. If she had anything to say, she would have come forward by now.
No, not necessarily. It's important to me, and it's important to Derek Reese, but it means damn all to her.
Join the club.
Pardon?
I just find it a little hard to understand, that's all. I mean... No. Nope, forget it. Never mind.
No, go on.
Do you know what I'll be doing tomorrow? I will be finalising the sale of McMahon's business, which has 200 employees and is valued at £2 million. And what will you be doing? You'll be legging it around the local shops in search of a missing coin, all on behalf of a guy on legal aid who behaved in, quite frankly, a stupid way, but whose suffering face is imprinted on your mind.
Well, I'll see you sometime tomorrow, eh? After I've legged it round the shops.
Sarah?
veteran Benny, given just 2 months to live, undergoes a liver transplant operation which could save her life at Jimmy's.